I always think about the first, you know, all of the women that came into the military before me, the first woman that went to the Air Force Academy, the first woman that went to space. And by being able to look at them, you can see yourself in their shoes. And so I think it's really cool that this upcoming generation, along with mine, gets to see a woman go to the moon. I'm Madison Marsh, Second Lieutenant in the United States Air Force and Miss America 2024. Yes, so I did it while I was at the United States Air Force Academy, and I had the pleasure of having so many amazing contacts that had constantly worked with NASA. And so I worked under Dr. Gibbs, and so he had some great contacts then at the NSSTC, which is the National Space and Science Technology Center, right here in Huntsville, Alabama. And I had the pleasure of studying gamma ray burst. And so I got to come down here, work in a lab, and kind of look at what it looks like for burst structures when gamma ray bursts are coming in and being detected on telescopes, to try to see if there's a way that maybe we could see that are similar structures between the gamma ray burst and maybe start to compartmentalize them between others and see if that means anything special. So that's kind of a high bird's view of what I got to do. I had always had a love of studying kind of the beginning of time, the universe and black holes. That was something from the day one at the Academy I always said that I wanted to look into. And so I joined the physics department at the Academy and kind of started working with different telescopes to do astronomy, and then slowly started to get into more of black hole research because the interconnections between gamma ray bursts and black holes were present. And so that was a really great way for me to get into that field by doing some preliminary research at the Academy and with NASA. I mean, it was really cool because I had never been in like an office space like that doing physics before. It's very different from kind of the classroom setting conventionally of what you do with physics. And so a lot of my work was kind of giving me the independence of now I'm here to do it on my own. Yes, I had an awesome boss that was kind of there to lead me to answer all the questions, but for the most part, I was in the office trying to figure out, looking at all of these graphs, seeing what it was even like, when I was gonna mess up, basically, and being able to have the confidence to go and ask my boss for those questions, being able to bring him the work that I had done and have them check it and say, you know, this is something that we might need to work on a little bit more. So it was really cool to have that leadership experience and for the first time experience in an office, kind of trying to do things on my own and learning through the whole process of failure and then going on and getting better the next time around. I would say pick everyone's brains. I mean, you are at a place where there is so much intellect and drive and passion and people that are doing different career paths all over. I know one of the things that my professors had me do is they set up meetings almost the entire time that I was interning there for 6 weeks. So I was constantly going and talking to more people about their research projects, going down to the Marshall Center and looking at some of the engineers, the rocket programs, watching propulsion tests. I mean, so many different things that were outside of the scope on what I was studying. And so that's the type of opportunity you have when you intern with NASA. People all over, different backgrounds, different research. And maybe that might open up your mind to say, I never thought about things like that before. Or maybe I don't want to just focus on, in my case, gamma ray bursts, but I could be interested in different studies. And so it really just broadens your whole view of how you can apply yourself to space. I think what I did is I just kind of went for every opportunity that had passed or that had come across my path, because there was so much that the Air Force had provided me, you know, research opportunities, people, and I had always put it out there to every single professor that I met, and I told them my dream. I told them that I wanted to be an astronaut and that I really wanted to study black holes. And just by being honest and open with them, they were able to kind of give me their expertise because they'd been in this profession for so long, and were able to kind of guide me, give me different options and opportunities to kind of take hold and also figure things out myself to find out what I was really passionate about. And so I think as long as you take hold of the people that are there to help you and also be honest with yourself about what your true passions are, any internship is going to be great. I if I were to be an astronaut, I would love to, like, I don't know, be whoever the person is doing the moonwalk or maybe going to Mars. I love science experiments. I know there's a lot of different research that gets done with cancer up in space. Cancer's my specialty in honor of my mom, and so I think doing something like that would be really cool and very meaningful. I would say I've kind of learned throughout the years that obviously you have a limited amount of hours in the day, and the things that you are most passionate about, you will make time for. But I think the way that you go about dealing with it is honestly giving time back for yourself. Because I had really tried to do 24 hours a day, always studying, always running my nonprofit, go, go, go. And it causes burnout really easily. And so I think the best change that I made was putting purposeful time throughout the week to read a book, to turn off my phone, to go out with my friends. And I think giving myself that space made me so much more productive in the hours that I was working, made me so much more productive to invite in all of my passions into my life. So I think you gotta take care of yourself first, and that's the only way you can go 110% out in your professional life. I think this goes for all women, but you really have to think outside of the boxes that society has tried to put women in. You have to be able to chase after whatever you are passionate about. Because I'm the very first active duty military member to be Miss America, and it's really cool now to wear this, but also getting to wear the uniform. And to be honest, pageants and the military have two very conflicting stereotypes, but I never let that stop me or hinder me from doing the things that I loved, because I was passionate about both paths. And so you have to be able to set aside what other people think, what other people want you to do, live your life, live it passionately. Whatever that means to you, just go after it, because we have a very limited amount of years on this earth. My mom passed away when she was 41 from pancreatic cancer, so I had to see that firsthand. So never waste a moment doing something that you don't love, and never waste a moment doing something for other people. You have to do it passionately for what's really in your heart. And so that's what I would say to all the young women out there trying to figure out where they're gonna go.